Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Conceal Carry Training with Max Michelle, presented by Galco. Shooting from alternate positions can be challenging, but there's a technique to everything that we do. Sure, if I'm shooting without a wall or a vision barrier in front of me, I'm gonna be in my normal shooting position with my stance very wide, butt out, chest forward for that aggressive recoil management. Now, in a situation where I'm shooting around an object, I might not be able to get into that position. So if I'm a right-handed shooter or a left-handed shooter, shooting from the right-hand side of the barricade, I wanna make sure that that right foot is forward. If my right foot is forward, it allows me to have that stability that I need for speed and accuracy, but more importantly, I can locate the inside of the range with balance. If my left foot was forward like it typically would be as a right-handed shooter, I might be able to locate the first target, but as I try to go deeper and deeper behind that wall, I'm gonna end up losing my balance. So I won't be very quick on that, and I'm gonna expose myself from the other side of that wall. So by having that right foot forward, it provides me the ability to be able to access the inside of the range and have that stability. Should I have somebody else in the room with me, stacking this room with me, if somebody was to hit me or bump me here, I have control of my body. If I had my left foot forward and I was kind of leaning around like so, if somebody was to bump me, I'm probably gonna fall out of that position. Another consideration is hand placement and mounting the pistol to the target. So as I'm approaching this position, I want to make sure that the gun is going out to the first threat that I see, and I simply transition through the remaining targets by increasing weight into that forward leg. But how close do we get to this position? I try to stay about an arm's length away from any vision barrier that I'm shooting from. And here's why. If I get too deep into this position, it takes time to get in and time to get out. And also I'm very jammed up here, so it's difficult to kind of transition through there or keep my balance. So if I stay at an arm's length away, that's gonna be key for me, but I wanna make sure that I'm keeping the pistol straight up and down. By keeping that gun straight up and down, it's gonna ensure that I'm not gonna be chipping away at this wood or hitting any vision barrier downrange, causing my bullet to deflect off target. Now that's how we shoot around a position, but let's say we have to rapidly approach that spot, or we have to run to locate cover to engage something from behind cover or concealment. How do we do that? So as I'm approaching this position, I want to make sure that I don't just run at full speed and then obviously fall out of this position by losing my balance. I need to make sure that I come in there nice and low and stable to be able to shoot quickly and effectively without losing my balance. So as I'm approaching this position, I want to get smaller steps or keep my feet under my body. Maybe I'm running 10 yards at this point, so I'm gaining some speed. But as I approach this wall or the window, doorway, port, whatever it is, I want to make sure my steps get smaller under my body. And as I approach this position, I do so with a heel first to soften the impact and then to slide that interior foot open to locate that inside target as well. So like I mentioned, shooting from alternate positions, it can be challenging, but there's a technique to all of it. If you're shooting from the right-hand side, that right foot should be forward. From the left-hand side of a vision barrier or a wall, that left foot should be forward to create that balance and stability that we need with speed and accuracy while accessing that inside of the range. Also, it's important to keep that gun straight up and down. If you roll that gun over, your sights or your dot might be seeing the target, but your muzzle is chipping away at the wood or the vision barrier, deflecting those rounds off target and maybe even bringing ricochets back your way. And you can see how easy this is to train. You can set it up on your home range, but be sure to do this in dry fire as well at home. Take no ammunition in the gun, no ammunition in the room, it's just you and the gun and your home, and kind of focus on your hallways, your doorways, your windows, whatever it might be, to provide that cover or concealment to be able to access those targets downrange.
Use code MAX15 for 15% off at galcoholsters.com.